I would like to give you a scenario. If you are sick, you go to the doctor and you explain your symptoms and they diagnose you with a problem and you get cured. If you want to acquire knowledge, you go to school and there's a lecturer who will teach you, there's a teacher who will explain the fundamentals of whatever it is that you're trying to learn. If you are feeling low in your spirit, you will go to church, you will go to the temple, you will go to the mosque, and the imam, the priest, or your spiritual leader will nourish your spirit. But who do you see if you are facing financial challenges? That is the job of a financial advisor. The reason that it is important for you to have an independent financial advisor is because they will give you an unbiased view of your financial health and explain to you where the gaps are and what stops you from achieving financial independence. It is important to note that the most critical thing when you engage a financial advisor is to be honest with yourself and to be honest with your financial advisor. The level of advice that you get is 100% dependent on the level of information that you give to your financial advisor. The second point that we'll look at to help guide you into financial well-being is retirement planning. Your retirement is actually the longest holiday of your life. And if you're going on holiday, you usually plan, you have a budget for it. Alexander Forbes released a report some time back where the statistics indicated that the average lifespan of a Kenyan after employment was only 2 years. Retirement planning is extremely important. The earlier you do it, the better for you. The rule of thumb is for people in their early 20s should save 10% of their current income to be able to live off half of their final salary. If you're 30, you have to start investing 20%. If you're one of the unfortunates who have not started investing by the time you are 40 and planning your retirement, you will be required to put away roughly 30% for you to retire on half of your salary at the age of retirement. I cannot stress enough how important it is for you to have either a company-sponsored retirement plan or to have an individual personal pension scheme. There are quite a number in the market, and depending on what you exactly want to achieve, sitting down with your financial advisor, they will be able to look at various service provider and also guide you in terms of what you are able to invest in. It is always possible for any investment for you to do it in Kenya shillings or in a hard currency. We always prefer to advise people to have their pension plans in a hard currency because of depreciation of the local currency against the US dollar, against the euro, or against the sterling pound. You would rather have a nest egg in a hard currency at the end of the day than you would have it in Kenya shillings.